Hello viewers, my name is Abhijit Taras and welcome back to another useful video that helps you to understand how to analyze and design a continuous beam using StatPro software. First of all, you need to open the StatPro software. You can do this by clicking on the desktop shortcut of the StatPro software. After the software opens up, the interface will be like this. First, click on the new project, then select plane and give a name to your file. You can change the location of your file depending upon your requirements. Then make sure that the length units in meter and force unit in kilonewton. Then click the next button. Then select add beam and then finish. Then the window will be like this. You can change the view side of the beam by using these rotational icons. We are using snap node beam method to draw the nodes and beams in this software. First, click on the snap node beam button and then draw your beam depending upon which length you need to draw the continuous beam. Here I am drawing a 3-spanned 3-meter interval beam to form a continuous beam. The full length of the continuous beam is 9 meter. By completing this, we completed the geometry phase. Then go to the general tab, which is at the left side of the work area. Then click on the property, click on the define button to define the length and the breadth of the beam. Here we have to select the shape of the beam as a rectangle and give the depth and breadth values as here. YD is the depth of the beam and ZD as the width of the beam. I am giving the values of YD as 0.45 meter and ZD as 0.3 meter. Then click the add button, then click close button. Then we have to assign the shape and size of the beam to the beam we drawn. Select the section we have created and then click on the assign to view and then click assign. After that, click S button. Now the size of the beam is assigned to the beam we drawn. Then go to the support tab to provide supports for this continuous beam. For that, click create and click on the fixer tab and then click add button. For continuous beam, we know that two ends of the beam are fixed, so that we are providing fixed supports at the two ends of the beam. We are assigning fixed supports at the end of the beam. And then we have to create the pinned supports. For that, click create and then click pinned, then click add button. Then we have to assign pinned supports for the intermediate joints of the continuous beam. Then click assign button. Then assign the pinned supports to the intermediate joints of the continuous beam. Then we have to go to the load and definition tab to add the loads to this beam. Then click on the load cases details and click add button. Then we have to select the load type as dead and we have to give any titles to this dead load, then click add, then select load type as live and click add. Then we need to consider the factor of safety of the beam, so that we need to click on the load auto load combination and we have to select the code as engine code and then click generate load. Then we have to select the factor of safety as 1.5 and then click add button and then close the tab. Then click on the load case 1 and then click add button and then select sulfate factor as minus 1 and click add button. Then click the close button. Then select the load case 2 or live load and then click the add button. Select member load. We are going to apply a uniform force of minus 2 kilonewton per meter for the first span of the continuous beam. Minus indicates that's the downward direction of the fold and then click the add button. After that, I am going to apply a concentrated force of minus 0.5 kN at 1.5 meter from the left edge of the second span of the continuous beam. And then click add button. Then again for the last span of the continuous beam, I'm going to add a force of minus 0.75 kN from 2 meters from the left edge of the third span. Then click add button. Then click close button. Then we have to assign the self weight to the total beam. For that, select the self weight and then click assign to view. Then assign and then click the S button. Then select the first span of the continuous beam and then select the UDL of minus 2 kN per meter and then select assign to selected beam, assign and then click S button. Similarly, assign the remaining two loads to the two spans of the continuous beam. Now the load and definition part is over. Then we have to go to the analyze and print tab and then select all and click add button, then close. Then click analyze, run analysis. When the analysis is completed, it shows the result. As you can see here, 0 errors, 0 warnings and 0 notes. It is important that to understand there is no error during the analysis of the beam. Then click the done and then go to the design tab and then select the material as concrete and then select code as IS456 and then select parameters FC and then hold control and then select FY main and FY secondary, then press OK button. Then we have to define the parameter. Here I am using M25 grade of concrete, so that enter the compressive strength of concrete as 25,000 kN per meter square, and also I am using steel as 4.5 Fe 4.5 steel, so that give the strength value of steel as 4.5 and 000 kN per meter square and FY secondary as the same, and then click add button, then click close button, then click on the command button and then click on design beam and then click add button, then close. Then we have to assign these four to the entire continuous beam. For that, select individual components and then click assign to view, then assign, then yes. They will complete the four elements as assigned to view. Then click analyze, then run analysis. As you can see, there is no error, no warnings and no note for this design. So this design is completely successful. Then select go to post processing mode, then click done button. In post processing mode, we can see the deflection, reactions and moment, bending moment diagram and shear force diagram of the beam while these loads are to be acted on the beam. Click on the MZ icon to see the bending moment diagram, as the bending moment value is very small, so that we have to press and hold the control button and scroll the mouse upwards to see the bending moment diagram. Now you can see the bending moment diagram. For the values given to this beam, the bending moment diagram will be like this. Then you can see the shear force value by clicking the FY button on the top of the working area and hold the control key and scroll mouse up to see the shear force diagram and the displacement as well. in this interface. Then go to the node and reaction tab to see the reactions developed by the continuous beam against these forces. To see the 3D view of the beam, right click on it on the work area and then click 3D rendering. Here you can see the 3D view of the continuous beam that we drawn. Or else we can view the 3D model of the beam by right clicking in the work area and structure, selecting the structure diagrams, then select full sections. Then click apply. Here we can see the full sections of the beam, and then click section outline and apply to see the section outline of the beam, and then click OK button. That's all, viewers. Now we have successfully completed the analysis and design of a continuous beam using StatPro software. Like this video if this video is useful for you, and subscribe to my channel for more related videos. And if you have any doubts regarding this video, please let me know in the comment section down below. Thanks for watching. See you in next video.